Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. I'm SE Cupp. Grim statistics, folks. The U.S. set a single-day record for new coronavirus cases. We're now approaching 3 million. That's as we're struggling to safely reopen the country, which we've done in some places, and in others, we've had to pull back. We're starting to go back to restaurants and stores, beaches and parks. And now, just a month or so away, it's back to school. But back to school takes on a whole other connotation this year. Instead of worrying and wondering about what kind of school supplies we'll need, pens, pencils, notebooks, we're worrying and wondering whether our kids will need masks, whether we'll need more buses, whether we'll need to keep our kids 6 feet apart. And by the way, how do you do that at recess? As a mom, it's terrifying. We have all worked so hard all spring and summer to stay safe. And with the ring of a bell, that could all have been for nothing if our schools can't keep our kids and our teachers healthy. Now, you'd think that doing just that would be the ultimate in priorities for our towns, states, federal government as the summer months wane. And yet, President Trump seems more concerned with politics than our kids. Now, believe me, I don't say that lightly, so let me explain. His administration has been publicly pressuring states to reopen schools soon. He himself has been turning up the heat, saying just this week, we're very much going to put pressure on governors and everybody else to open the schools. And then, of course, following that up with a tweet threatening to cut off funding to schools that don't. Well, okay, sure, you might say. Who doesn't want our kids to go back to school? They need school, and they need to interact with kids their own age. Believe me, I get it. And for millions of working parents, we also need our kids in school, too. We are not full-time teachers. I'm not. We have to go back to work eventually, and that will be good for our families and our economy. All of that is fine. There are plenty of very good reasons to want our schools to reopen, and soon. But here's how I know that the president's motivations are self-serving and not in the best interest of our kids and families. Because his demand for school reopenings comes with exactly, precisely, no tools or resources for doing it safely. It's as if Trump said to fire departments around the country, go put out all the fires now, but then gave them no equipment to do it with. His education secretary, Betsy DeVos, has offered little in the way of help, instead shrugging off the challenge by saying, education leaders need to examine real data and weigh risk. Risk is involved in everything we do, from learning to ride a bike to riding a rocket into space and everything in between. Got that? It's up to teachers and education leaders, just not her, to figure out how to do this right. And yeah, the rocket might explode in space in the process. Now, upon Trump's decree to reopen now or else, Florida immediately announced it would reopen for five-day-a-week schooling in August. That's just as coronavirus cases there have spiked. So the president of the Florida Education Association told CNN, we've been given no guidance. We've been given no regulations that make sense to reopen our schools. And in the middle of a pandemic, we're being told we have to reopen schools come hell or high water? That the president of the United States hasn't made it his number one agenda item to give states a plan to reopen and the money, PPE, testing capabilities, and other resources to do it safely is unconscionable. Instead, Trump is busy tweeting, golfing, and politicizing the issue by warning that Democrats are politicizing the issue. He tweeted, corrupt Joe Biden and the Democrats don't want to open schools in the fall for political reasons, not for health reasons. They think it will help them in November. Wrong, the people get it. Of course, Trump is worried about his own re-election bid, which is facing headwinds thanks to his tanking poll numbers and a disapproval over his handling of this pandemic. He knows he needs suburban women to win, and getting the economy running again, well, it's very important to them. But as a suburban woman, I can say it's not important at all costs. Now, if you'd have told me months ago that in the face of a global pandemic that has killed 500,000 people worldwide, Americans would be playing politics with face masks, with one side saying, sure, wearing masks makes sense, and the other side saying, masks are for liberal pansy elites, I would have laughed in your face, and hopefully you'd be wearing a mask when I did so. No way we're that dumb. And yet Trump managed to even turn health science into a culture war for his own edification. And now, grotesquely, he's trying to do the same with our schools and our kids. It's shameful. All right, that's it for me. See you next time.